Oh, Jacob, Evie, it's you. Thank goodness.
Experimenting, are we, Alec?
Correct.
And looking a bit frazzled.
Nerves. It's those great oafs Static keeps sending round to coax me. He is offering a ridiculous amount of money.
Alec, you're not thinking of jumping ship, are you?
Never. I've been working in something in case they get too insistent. It's meant to stun an assailant, should the need arise.
Are you certain that it works?
Not as such. I've made three of them with varying degrees of acidity and whatnot. Oh, one must be the right formula.
Let's find some Staric lackeys to target then, shall we?
Speaking of Staric, he is still transmitting false information.
We could simply destroy his transmitters.
His company's too well guarded. The bombs will help, but it would be awkward to produce bombs that potentially do not stun. Oh, wait a minute. Looks like opportunity has come knocking. Oh dear, you never looked so angry before.
Stand clear, Alec.
Let us instead play a little linguistic game with them. Take the bombs and climb onto the roof. When I see the name of a fruit, toss one near the thugs.
Right then.
I nearly forgot. Slip these into your boots and you will henceforth be immune to all voltaic discharge. I think.
Gentlemen, I would ask you in for tea, but I'm afraid I'm running rather late.
Enough of the niceties. We've come to smash your place up, ain't we, Bess?
You got one of them telly what's it's in here, ain't ya? You've been reading messages from the Staric Company.
That is as untrue as the notion that the Staric Telegraph Company is emitting impartial information, sir.
Come again?
Your employer's promises are nothing but hot air. His operations are about to turn pear-shaped.
What you going on about air and pears, Hulk?
Oh, I don't know, I feel rough.
Oh, that's disgusting.
Kids, huh? Those playful young scamps get everywhere.
Listen up, Bell, or I'll thump you till your ears are ringing.
Your wordplay delights me. And to think I worried you had the mental agility of a dollop of donkey's apple.
He's trying to be funny.
Oh, you dropped a no-one, Bill. You little sod.
What? Ain't me, Bez. Oh, go blimey, it's got me through.
Oh, those rascals throwing stink bombs again. It happens all the time around here.
Where you keep that telly, what's it? I'll count to three.
Three? Well, well, let's see how far you get.
One.
Do you really think I would keep it here? Do you see a cable? A telegraph without a cable is about as useful as a bell without a clapper.
I'll give you a bleeding clapper.
Well, bless my boots, you're as purple as a plum.
Yes!
Oh. Two! Down! Gosh!
relic.
Thanks to you, Evie. Your mere presence gave me courage and resolve I never knew I had.
I'm glad I could help. Now it's time to shut down Stark's empire of propaganda.
The longer we can keep Starek from spewing out false information, the more we can awaken the people with the truth about his operations.
I agree. The sooner we can get there, the quicker we can act.
Would you believe my mother says there are still some wives in her street that swear by that soothing syrup? So I took it upon myself to tell her neighbors the truth about the noxious draft.
That's good, Alec. But you can't go round to every household in London town.
No, I wasn't always welcome. It shows how false information can be as difficult to stamp out as fishwives, profanities, and Billingsgate.
Or vermin at Smithfield.
But if we can eradicate a source that continually feeds such detrimental trash, then little by little the truth will take the upper hand and the sham will be flushed out.
That's why we're here.
We will have to get in without being detected, mind.
I shall stun them while you get inside.
I shall destroy not one, but three parts of the transmitter. You'll be as good as dancing before a public toilet without a penny.
Slowly. Atta girl.
Over here.
Faster if you can.
Once again in order for supporting what is most dear to me and to our cause, freedom of speech.
It's a blessing that you employ your genius for the common good, Alec.
However, I suggest you vacate your workshop.
No need. Not now. You've given me sacks full of courage. And, besides,
What with my little devices, I have all the protection I need. Should you find yourselves with a moment to spare, do drop by.
Miss Fry, what a pleasant surprise.
Hello, Clara. I was just going to check on Lambeth since the asylum's closing. What brings you here?
The children in my care have been falling ill. Our usual tonics aren't working. I came to...
Are you certain you're feeling all right?
Of course. I am, miss.
Clara! Is there a doctor nearby?
Bring her inside. She simply collapsed?
Yes, she said the others took tonic, but it didn't work.
I should think not. Ever since Elliotson was murdered, the district has been overrun with counterfeit tonics. This one needs proper care. But without the appropriate medication, she and the others will quickly decline.
What do you need?
I need supplies. Plenty of them. And medicine. Some of the less common ingredients are being stolen and sold at auction.
I'd be happy to help.
Here's the list. Miss...
Fry. Evie Fry.
I'm Miss Nightingale. How do you do? Please hurry. We don't have much time.
Come on.
Health?
Please.
Therefore, whoever pays the most money.
Yes, sir!
I can't thank you enough. These supplies are meant for Miss Nightingale.
I'm here to collect them.
And they're already loaded on the cart. Please take them.
Giddy up!
You mean that cart?
Yes.
Of course it is.
Please be careful. Some of those items are fragile.
Here now.
Move it!
That's it.
You're back. And not a moment too soon. I hope you brought the medication I requested.
How is she?
She will recover.
Babylon Ellie, the children.
Thanks to you, we can distribute authentic medicine now.
But is that a permanent solution?
I will petition to have regulations put in place.
Lambeth is in your debt.
It takes a long time to change things. But I'm not going anywhere, Miss Fry.
Thank you. the engine just pulled into Waterloo. Once Stark's men arrive, they're gonna unload the train.
Well, not if the train has already left. Assemble a team at Charing Cross. I'll send the engines there for you to recover.
Schedule.
Central station's closed. Attaway's orders.
You saw these blueprints, did you not? Were you aware of this flaw?
It's only a minor weakness, sir. The vital wagon's otherwise fortified.
It's usually punctual.
What this could be causing this delay?
I'm going to miss my train.
Once the order comes through, we will send you on your way to the central station. My colleague should be here shortly with the schedule for the central station. We thank you for your patience.
I need to get to the central station.
You and this whole lot. It won't happen until I have my train notices. Come on, Chief, where are you?
And you tell everyone who asked about our business.
Well,
you do, don't you? Unbloody believable.
It's only happened an handful of times.
You'll fucking pay for that!
About your business.
Once the order comes through, we will send you on your way to the central station.
Here's your damn schedule.
Thank you.
Attention, passengers!
I have urgent business in the central station.
It's usually punctual.
This is absolutely absurd. I'm going to miss my train.
What in the world is happening?
It doesn't take much to lead a few of these Jossers astray.
Thank you. Remember your training now. You can face anything.
Something's wrong here.
What would be his profession or do that again?
What a shame. Good partnerships are hard to come by.
Ours is most certainly dissolved.
It's business, Mr. Fry. One does what one must to come out on top. Crawford will not take the news of my death lightly. He can be unpleasant when he's cross. I have sacrificed so much. I don't want to lose my buses.